POTS.
Postural
orthostatic
tachycardia syndrome.
POTS is a syndrome that really has two criteria, but a lot of associated features. People with POTS have orthostatic intolerance, that is, they don't tolerate standing up, and they have an exaggerated orthostatic tachycardic response. Their heart rate goes up more than it should when they stand up.
When you stand and gravity is displacing blood downward, your brain senses that and makes your heart beat faster, makes it beat more forcibly, and tells the blood vessels in the lower half of the body to become three times tighter than what they were before. That tightening pushes blood upwards towards the brain. And in POTS, they're unable to either make or maintain that tightening of blood vessels. And so blood is pulled by gravity downward. The brain, trying to compensate, will then tell the heart to beat harder and faster. And frequently it compensates enough to prevent the person from losing consciousness, but nonetheless is unable to maintain the same levels of perfusion or blood flow to the brain and other organs that were previously present.
The problem with POTS is that it is a syndrome, meaning that it encompasses different symptoms. And people do not only complain of their heart racing, but they can complain of a zillion other things.
Shortness of breath, tightness of chest,
lightheadedness,
fibromyalgia,
dizziness,
malnutrition,
brain fog,
stomach problems,
light sensitivity, sound sensitivity,
GI tract shutdown,
headaches,
random body pain. Sometimes everywhere hurts.
Fainting.
Heat intolerance.
Blood pooling.
Irritable bowel syndrome.
New onset allergies.
Fatigue.
Tingling.
I think there's about 100 more.
As you see, it's almost every organ of the body that is affected by this constellation of symptoms. POTS is not an isolated syndrome. It is part of a continuum, of a spectrum of conditions that range from very mild to very severe. And the common link is the autonomic nervous system. So for this reason, we put POTS as one of the major manifestations of autonomic dysfunction, or what we also call dysautonomia.
Although originally we only had a very simple set of criteria to diagnose, and now we realize that it comes with a whole package, and most patients have the whole package.
It gets treated in a variety of ways. A lot of us as physicians have our own individualized approaches. I try and look at the most important factor contributing to that person's POTS.
Just because someone doesn't look sick doesn't mean they aren't sick. A lot of the patients actually look like young, healthy women. You know, I think if someone was missing a leg, I don't think anyone would question that something's happened and probably have more empathy. I think that sometimes is tougher for patients with POTS because they don't visibly look sick.
How many people have POTS? In all our experiences here, we all can say that we are overwhelmed with patients who have this condition.
We started to recognize the first cases of POTS around 1993. Of course, at that time, lots of doctors thought this doesn't exist. But as the time went on, people realized, no, this is real, and there's a diagnosis for it. And now it's undeniable. We have major centers involved, major university programs that are really in the front lines of research.